Hello, my name is Jason Johnson, and thank you for watching my videos. This video series is on the Raptor program for flowchart-based programming. This video is an if-then statement using nested, or an example of nested. So let's take a look here. Let's say that we've been hired as a mystery shopper, and we need to do the ratings from 1 to 10. And we've looked at this in a previous video, so I'm going to keep this one short. We are going to develop a program that gives a rating based on 0 through 10, or 1 through 10. And if our score is a 10, then we're going to get a rating of an A. If it's a rating of an 8 or a 9, then it gets a B. If it's a 6 or a 7, it gets a C. And then anything else gets a D. So let's take a look here. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to open up our Raptor program, and we're going to set some variables to begin with. So we're going to put an assignment on the board here, and we're going to call this variable of score, and we're going to set that to 0. Then we're going to do another assignment, and we're going to set the rating to A, and we're going to do this lowercase a. We could set that to 0. We could set it to a number, but we're going to go ahead and show that this is an alpha number, and so we're going to set it to lowercase a, and then we're going to ask the user to give us some input. And in this case, we're going to say enter score, and we're going to set this variable for score. Now we're going to do a decision, and on this decision here, we're going to say, is the score equal, and we're going to use double equals, is it equal to 10? We're going to say that. And if it's a yes, we're going to do an assignment to say, now we're going to set rating. We're going to change the rating from a lowercase a to an uppercase a. So if it was a yes, we do the rating here. If it was a no, what we're going to do is we're going to add another selection on here. And we're going to put a selection of no here. And this was similar to the other if-then statements that we've done. But in this case, we're going to say, and I'm going to use my cheat notes here because it's easier to copy. And if it's going to say a score of equal to 8 or a score of equal to 9, if it was a yes, then we're going to go ahead and set our assignment in here. And we're going to change our rating to a capital B. We're going to slide over here. And if it was a no, we're going to nest another selection underneath here. Instead of setting it below, we're going to nest it. And on this one, we're going to set our score. Is it 6 or 7? Is it equal to 6 or a 7? If it was a yes, we're going to set an assignment, and we're going to call this rating, and we're going to call this one a C. So A, B, and C so far, and we've nested this. If it was no in this case, we're going to say if it was a yes, set the rating to C. Otherwise, if it's anything else, if it's not a 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 6, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then we're going to set an assignment over here on the no side, and we're going to say if everything else, then change the rating to a D. If it's anything other than a 6 through a 10, then go ahead and change it to a D if it's anything else. And then we could output to the user, but in this case, we're not going to. We're just going to end the program. So let me make this a little bit larger here, and let's do a step through. And let's test this with a 10 first. So let's test this with an 8. So we're going to set the score to 0. We're going to set our rating to A, and now we're going to ask the user, and let's set this to an 8. So over on the left-hand side, our score changes to an 8, and it's going to say, did it go to yes? No, because it's not equal to 10. Is it equal to 8 or a 9? In this case, it's a yes, so it's going to change our rating to B, and then it's going to end the program. Let's do this again, but let's set it with a 3, and that's our symbols evaluated there. So let's go with this, do this again. So we're going to set our score to 0, our rating to our lowercase a. We're going to ask a score, and we're going to say a 3. So this case, it's going to be no there. It's going to be no here. It's going to be no on 8 or 9, a no on a 6 or a 7. And in this case, since it's a no there, it's not going to go to C. It's going to go to a rating of D. It's going to change our rating to a D, and then it's going to end the program. So this is an example of nested if-then statements. In the previous one, we looked at where they were sequential or in line. This one is what we're doing with nested. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. If you're one of my students, make sure that you email me from within the course. I hope you have a great day. Stay safe, and remember to be excellent to each other.